Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra once again. And in our last video, we have discussed about verbs and verbals. And there, we have assured that we are returning very soon with the parts of verbals, and the first of them is today. Yes dear friends, today we are going to discuss in detail about infinitives, the first types of verbals. So let's begin our discussion regarding infinitives. But before we start our discussion, I must say you something. If you haven't go through the verbs and verbals properly, their differences and their relations, I would ask you to check the video from the I button above. There I have put the link. And first you have to get the knowledge of verbs and verbals, then steps to infinitive, and you find it very much interesting to learn infinitive. And obviously the process of learning for infinitive is going to be very easy for you as well. So let's our discussion about infinitive begin. So what is infinitive? We have already discussed that an infinitive has actually the force of a verb. So it's action word, but it lacks the action. Rather, it is used as either a noun or an adjective or an adverb. So it's a verb in one hand and a noun or an adjective or an adverb in the others. So it partakes the nature of both a verb and some other parts of speech, specifically noun and adjective and adverb. I've repeated it for so many times so that you can remember it, you can store it into your mind, and you never forget. Yes dear friends, repetition is the best option to learn and to remember. So this is the secret of easy learning and easy remembering. Do it repeatedly. So whatever it may be, now we discuss about infinitives and their structures. Yes dear friends, you know it very much. An infinitive is constructed by adding verb with two. So two plus verb. No, it's not complete. It remains incomplete. Why? Because it's not only two plus verb, but the base form of the verb. What is the base form? This is the root form of the verb. Without any tense, nothing else. So how it goes, suppose we consider it as a verb, say play. So to play, that's infinitive. So this is all about definition and structure. But is this all? No, it's not. Still, you have a lot to learn. This video is going to get a bit lengthy, so you have to stay tuned and learn till the end, because we have many things to learn, a lot of things to learn about infinitives. Yes dear friends, my intention when I teach is very much different. I don't want you to learn the theory only. Rather, I want you to learn what its practical uses, because to learn theory is of no use if you don't know how to use them and where to use them. So my focus would remain the structure, the types, and also the different uses that we have for infinitives. So let's begin our discussion regarding different types of infinitives. So let's start. Yes, dear friends, different types of infinitives. So the first of them is common infinitives, but they are of several types. Don't get confused. I'll take much time, but I'll discuss them in very detail so that you would find it very easy to learn and very easy to remember as well. So the first of them is present infinitive, where we use two plus base form of the verb. That is, you may consider it as to go, to do, as it's there. Then comes what? Yes, present continuous infinitive. So how does it go? To be going or to be doing? So that's how present continuous infinitive goes. Then comes perfect infinitives. So how do we form perfect infinitives? To have gone, or then comes perfect continuous infinitives to have been going or to have been doing. And then comes what? Then comes, yes, present infinitive passive, to be done, to be gone, and also perfect infinitive passive, to have been done, to have been gone. So if you want to remember all these types of infinitives, it's very easy. Just remember their three basic types. Actually, we must say two basic types, present and perfect. So present infinitive gets present infinitive and present continuous infinitives, then gets perfect infinitive for perfect infinitives and perfect continuous infinitives. Then comes the third, that is the passive form of present infinitive and present perfect infinitives. So these are the six basic types of infinitives that we have to discuss here, and we have completed it, and now we'd shift something that's very much interesting, because I have told you whenever you form an infinitive we use two, but there's some occasions where we use infinitives without two, and these infinitives are called bare infinitives. Why do we need use bare infinitives? Because there's some verbs where with them they don't accept a normal infinitive, rather they accept a bare infinitive, and for them we do this without two and we call it bare infinitive. So now we'll learn what is a bare infinitive and how it works. So let's have some examples first. You had better wait for him. If you consider this sentence, you had better wait for him. So here actually you had better wait, that means better to wait for him, and the to has been omitted here because of better, and we call it what? We call it bare infinitives. Bare infinitives are also used in many other places. Yes, after modal auxiliaries, actually we use bare infinitives. If I say I will go, he will play, you will do. So what it actually mean? He will play, it actually means he will to play, but we don't use the to, and here play is not a verb, rather this is a bare infinitive. So that's all about bare infinitives, and now we'd shift to something else, another types of infinitives. Now what's this is? Yes, sometimes they're parted. Sometimes the construction of infinitives, that is to plus verb, gets parted and something is put in between. But here I must say, this is not advisable to part an infinitive, but in some situations you are compelled to do this. And when it's done, that means when to and verb are get separated and some other word gets placed in the middle of it, we call it split infinitives. So let's check out what is a split infinitives by finding out some examples. It demands much effort to really learn something. Yes, I'm repeating the sentence. It demands much effort to really learn something. So here to learn, these two components of an infinitive has been parted. Why? Because we have put really between them, and the infinitive, the construction of infinitive gets split. So this is called split infinitive. So that's another type. There's also other types, and this is no less interesting than the previous ones. So what's this? Here sometimes you'd find some infinitives where you put the to but not the verb. Why? Because here we want to avoid unwanted repetitions of the verb. Sometimes for the infinitives, the verbs gets repeated and the repetition of the verb doesn't sound well. That's why sometimes we have to drop the verb and put to instead. So let's check out how it works. Somewhere we are dropping the verb, keeping to, and somewhere we are dropping to and keeping the verb. So that's the different constructions that we follow, that's the different forms of infinitives that we follow in English sentences. So let's check out what example is there for it. Do you swim? No, but I used to. Do you swim? No, but I used to. So once upon a time, he used to swim. So I used to swim. That swim would have been a repetition. We have found it in the question and also in the answer. That's why it gets understood. Because of the question, we know what action has been spoken of here. That's why you have dropped swim and the answer comes, no, I used to. So this is what we use sometimes for infinitives with to, dropping the verb. So dear friends, we have already learned about the forms and structures and types of infinitives. Now it's time for us to learn their uses. So let's learn the different uses of infinitives. Obviously, they are very much essential for you to learn properly. So let's start our learning of the uses of infinitives. So the first of them. So if we talk an infinitive, we must know where it can be placed. So if you consider an infinitive, it can be placed where? Singularly and also in an infinitive phrase. How? If we say the choir began to sing, to sing. So this is singularly used infinitive. Now, if we say the choir began to sing in a harmony. Now, began to sing in a harmony, to sing in a harmony, this is an infinitive phrase. So that's how an infinitive can be used as singularly and also in an infinitive phrase. So there comes our second uses of an infinitives. Yes, dear friends, as you have already learned that an infinitive is a noun. So it simply means an infinitive can be used in those positions where a noun is used. And what are they? A noun can be used as the subject of a verb. So following these rules, we can use an infinitive as a subject of a verb. As it's in the sentence, to a is human, here to a, it works as the subject of a verb. So an infinitive can work as the subject of a verb. And also, as you know, what can happen for a noun? It can be used as a complement as well. So an infinitive can be used as a complement too. So how it works, let's check out. The example says, his intention was to find out the treasure. His intention was to find out the treasure. So to find out, this infinitive is actually a complement. You have already learned copulative verbs. So is, it takes a complement, and to find out is the complement for these verbs. So let's check out the fourth uses of infinitives. An infinitive can be used either as an object or a part of an object. How it is? Let's check out the example. He wants to learn. So here, he wants what? To learn. So to learn, this infinitive has been used as, yes, an object. So let's check out what comes next. Do you want to express a command or an instructions? Yes, dear friends. For a command and instruction, you can seek help from an infinitive as well. How? He is to stay here till I return. So he is to stay here till I return. This is an expression of command. So you can utter this in a commanding tone, and it could be a comment, or if you instruct it to someone, it would be an instruction. Yes. So finally, what we get, to put a command or an instruction, we can use infinitives. Now it's time to get serious. To express a purpose, you can seek help from infinitives. Check the sentence. To express a purpose, you can seek help from infinitives. So this is the example, and also this is the theory as well. This is the uses of infinitives. You can use infinitives for expressing a purpose as well. So let's check out what's waiting for us in the next position. I'm glad to say I have so many supporters to help me. I'm repeating the sentence. I'm glad to say I have so many supporters to help me. Yes, dear friends, infinitives are used with certain words. What are they? Like glad, happy, sorry. So these are the words which follows an infinitive. So after these words, we use an infinitive. And there comes the next one. So let's check out what's waiting for us. What's the next uses of infinitives? Yes, dear friends. Could you imagine that an infinitive can be used as a conjunction to set a link between clauses? Yes, it happens. How? Here's an example. The major returns only to find out the camp empty. So if we consider this sentence, the major returns only to find out the camp entry. So to find out. Now, if we use the same sentence in different way, the major returns and he found the camp entry. So he found the camp empty. One sentence, the major return, this is other sentence. And when we make a connection in between these two sentences, we use an infinitive, and the infinitive is used here as a conjunction or as a connector to join sentences together. Now, we have another uses of infinitives. Yes, dear friends, infinitives can sometimes replace a relative clause. How it is? Suppose we have a sentence. He is the person who we can talk to. He is the person who we can talk to. Now, if you want to replace the relative clause, you have to use what? Yes, an infinitive. He is the person to talk to. He is the person to talk. So what we have done, we have replaced the relative clause with the infinitives, and you use it where? In your do as directed questions or transformation of sentences, where you have to transform a complex sentence into a simple sentence with a relative clause. Most of the time, this infinitive come into use to replace it and make the complex sentence simple. There's another, and it's also very much important. So let's check out what's the next. The infinitives are sometimes used after a noun. Yes, after some nouns we put an infinitive. So how it is? Here's an example. He makes all effort to save his people. He makes all efforts to save his people. So here we have used infinitive to shave after effort, and that's a noun. So let's check out what comes next. Now we are going to discuss something, another use of infinitives, and this use is very vital because most of the time I have found people actually making so many mistakes with this. So let's learn the rules first, then I'd come to the mistake that we made. So what's the rules? The rules is an infinitive can be used with to and enough. To and enough. And also it comes with the adjectives and also some other adverbs. So let's check out an example to find out the use of infinitive with to. Are you too sleepy to learn? Are you too sleepy to learn? So after to, we use what? We use to learn, that is an infinitive. Now what mistakes do we make? Yes, most of the time we use to replace very without understanding the fact that actually to means negative. If you say, if you suppose have written in the comment, sir, you are too good. So what I would find, I would find out that actually you are criticizing me, you are saying, no, I'm not so good. So, dear friends, it's really very important. You must remember that most of the time, to means negative. So, it can be used with infinitive, but also with care, because whenever you use to, put infinitive after this, or it would mean something else. But if I said you too sleepy to learn, so actually I'm criticizing you, na? So let's learn what comes next in our learning of the uses of infinitives. So now what we are going to learn, an infinitive phrase can be used. So this is more about position than uses. So we can use an infinitive phrase at the beginning of a sentence. How? An example is essential, na? To tell the truth, that's all we have to discuss today. To tell the truth, this is the infinitive phrase that has been used before the sentence and then the main sentence. And that's all for today. The video has already got very long. I don't want to linger it further, but you have left so many different things to learn about infinitives. We have to learn this in details. So another video is coming on the uses of infinitives in details. So stay tuned to the channel. Like it, subscribe it, and obviously if you have found it useful, don't forget to share it with your friends and families. So we are going to meet very soon, and for this session it's time to say goodbye.